Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next topic, that is a minimization of a finite automata, guys. Okay, so in the last few lectures, we have designed many DFAs, right? Yes, and to be clear, whenever we design a DFAs, sometimes your friend's diagram and your diagram might not match exactly, right? So even when you paused the video and you have drawn on your own, sometimes I used lesser states or you used more states, or sometimes you used lesser states and I used more states, right? And in examination, if this is the case, at that time there will be a huge confusion with respect to these options, right? Yes, so that is the reason why always in examination, whenever they are giving, they will give the minimized finite automata, guys. So to be clear, if you are having 100 different automatas for a single question, if you minimize all of them, every one of those 100 will be same, guys. So that is the main reason why minimization is that much important, and it is always a unique result, okay? Yes, so I think if we take a small example, it will be really easy for us, right? Yes, so let us try to minimize this expression, guys, okay? So I know that everyone will be interested if I teach first steps, but I think rather than teaching steps, if we understand the approach, then it will be really easy for us to understand the steps, right? Yes, okay, so assume that the given diagram is in this way. Okay, so A, B, Q2, this is also a final state, from here to here A, from here to here A, here self loop B, okay? Yes, so now my goal is to minimize this particular thing, okay? So the first thing you need to observe here is there any unreachable state, guys? So what do I mean by unreachable state is, so if I start at this point, I can never reach that location. So if I am here, I can go to Q1. If I am here, I can go to Q1. From Q1, I can go to Q2. But if you observe, can I go to Q3 in any way, guys? So to be clear, Q3's arrows are outwards, right? And there are no arrows towards it. Means indirectly, we can never reach Q3, right? So if we can't reach it, then why is it in the diagram, guys? So let us remove it. So once I removed it, so the diagram will look in this way, right? Yeah. I'll be taking multiple examples with respect to this minimization, guys. So don't worry or don't get scared that we are not having that much clear idea. Okay. Yes. So you will understand it slowly. So don't worry. Okay. Yes. Yeah. So now we got this as our result, right? Yes. So now what we do is, so now there are no unreachable states, right? Yes. So now I think we can search for some equal states. Okay. So now what we do is, we make sets, guys. So the first set is non-final states. So among Q0, Q1, Q2, which is non-final? Q0 is non-final. Among these three, which is final? Q1 and Q2. So we are making them into two different states, non-final and final. Okay, so now if you observe, so once we have separated them, so now start analyzing the thing, guys. So from Q0, if I get A, I will go here, go to Q1. If I get B, I will stay here only. Similarly, if I from Q1, if I get A, okay, I will go to Q2. If I get B, I will stay in myself. Similarly, Q2, if I get A, I will go to Q1. If I get B, I will stay in myself. So to be clear, if you observe here, non-final state is once going into non-final and the other time it is going to final. But when you are checking Q1 and Q2, both of them are acting same, right? So they are mapping to themselves in both A and B. So I'm having a suspicion among them that they are equal. So Q1 is equals to Q2. So that is what we can conclude based on this case. So now we can conclude that Q0 implies A, implies B. So now I can replace that Q2 by Q1. So this is the final state and A comma B will be the result. So this is the result. And what is this, guys? So this diagram is what, guys? It is nothing but having A, substring A, right? Yes. So now you understood, right? So how exactly we have minimized it? Yes. Okay. Yes. So now I hope everyone is getting at least some basic idea, right? Yes. So now let us go through the theory. Okay. So the process of eliminating of states whose presence or absence does not affect the language accepting capability of deterministic finite automata is called as minimization of DFA. So the best minimized possibility we are going to check, right? Yes. Okay, yes. So it is of two things, guys. So the first thing is a productive states and the second are non-productive states. So what are productive? Productive are nothing but the mandatory states which are needed, right? Yes. So when it comes to non-productive, so these can be removed, right? So the states might be dead state, or it might be an unreachable state, it might be an unequal state. So to be clear, if there is a particular DFA and if there is more than one dead state, you can remove all the dead states, and it should, the dead state count should be equal to 1 or it can be equal to 0, guys, at max. It can never be 2 or 3. So if there are 2 or 3, just combine them all into a single one, okay? Yes. So when it comes to unreachable state, as the name itself says, it is an unreachable state. So I think we can directly delete it, right? Yes. Moving on to equal state. So you, if you are 100% confirmed that two states are equal, you can equate them, right? Yes. So using our method, so we used this final state, non-final state method, right? You can use that method to identify, okay? Yes. So dead state. So created to make the system complete can be defined as a state for which there is no transition possible to the final state, right? Yes. When it comes to unreachable state, so it is that state which cannot be reached from the starting or initial state by passing an input string. Got it? Yes. Moving on to equal states. Two states are said to be equal if they map to the same final or non-final state. Got it? Yes. So now let us take one more example, and the next few examples we'll be discussing in our next lectures, guys. Okay? Yes. So let us take the next example. Okay. So this is the next example, guys. So Q naught. Okay, 0, 1, Q1, 0, Q0, Q2, 1, Q3, okay, from here if I give 1, I am going to Q4, this is a self loop, here with 1, here with 1. Okay, yes. I think I did some mistake here. So if I am having 1, I am going to Q4. So this is a 0, guys. Okay, yes. Okay, so here we are having 0, 1. 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 Okay, everything is done. So now what I told you, guys. So first check, is there any dead state here? So if you go to that state, you can never come outside of it. So that's not there. Moving on, is there any unreachable state? I think no. So now we need to check whether there are equal states or not. So among these all, how many are non-final, guys? So Q0 is non-final, Q1 is non-final, Q2 is non-final, Q3 is non-final. So the only state which is a final is a Q4, right? Yes. So now let us start mapping them. So if I give Q0, if I give a 0 or 1, I will be in this non-final states only. Similarly for Q1, if I give 0 or 1, so if I give 1, I will go here. If I give 0, I will stay here only. Similarly, when it comes to Q2 also, if I give 1, I will go here. And if I give 0, I will stay here only. Moving on to Q3, for Q3 also, if I give 1, I go here. If I give 0, I will stay here only. So to be clear, I observed a pattern here. So indirectly, these three people are doing the same thing, right? So they are mapping, if we are giving 1, they are mapping towards a Q4. And when we are giving 0, they are internally playing among themselves, right? So Q1 to Q2, Q3 to Q2, Q2 to Q1. So indirectly, they are playing among themselves. So I think we can conclude that we can separate these three into a single chunk, right? Okay, so Q0, because they are acting in the same way, I want to just cross check it once. Okay, Q4. Okay, so now I think there is no need of checking this, right? So Q0 will be mapping towards them only. Okay, when it comes to Q1, Q2, Q3, so three of them will be mapping towards it when we are talking about 1, and they are going to map among themselves when we are mapping with respect to 0. So I think based on this simple understanding, I think we can conclude that all these three are equal, right? So Q1 equal to Q2 equal to Q3. So now if I convert it into that diagram, so it will look in this way, right? So Q0, if I give 0 or 1, it will move to Q1, and from Q1, if I give 1, and if I give 0, it is going to be a self loop. If I give 1, it will go to Q4, right? And Q4 is the final state. It will be 0, 1 self loop. So now this is the start state. So basically, what is it, guys? So it is a nothing but in the initial, it might be anything. So it might be 0 or 1, but I need at least 1 in between, right? So at least 1 is mandatory. 1 is mandatory, right? Yes. So this is the minimized version of that. Got it? Yes. So in the same way, there are various questions in our book, guys. I request you to solve them. Anyway, I'll be solving few of those questions in the next lecture. So before watching the lecture, please note down these questions and try solving them, guys. So this is the first question. This is the second one. This is the third one. Okay, yes. So these are the three questions which we'll be discussing anyway in the next lecture. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this normalization, right? Yes. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question, right? Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.